All right.
Hey everyone, Josh Merhar here, and today I'm going to show you how to break your drum fills. Plain old eighth notes and triplets are for gigs, but no one's playing gigs right now, so let's get weird. These exercises will really help improve your ability to feel 16th and 16th triplet upbeats, and will hopefully demonstrate how we can still play some really cool fills without whipping out all the crazy chops. Everything I'm about to demonstrate is written out and available on my Patreon page, as well as a bunch of other combinations which are not demonstrated in this video. Click the link in the description to learn more, but let's get into it here. The concept is simple. We're just going to play eighth notes using single strokes, but offset them by a 16th so we play on only the E and of each beat. To get the feel for this, we'll start by playing regular eighth notes on the snare while keeping quarter notes on the kick to anchor the time, and then we'll switch to playing only the 16th upbeats on the snare. Doing so gets real tricky the faster you go, so start slow and steady. To further test your ability to keep your hands on those 16th upbeats without the time drifting, try playing the kick on only beats 1 and 3 under the same exercise. The urge to snap back onto the beat is strong, but you gotta fight through it. We could do the same thing with eighth triplets too. To start, I'll play single strokes on the snare, and then I'll nudge them back by a single 16th triplet. And I'll still keep quarter notes on the bass drum to anchor the time. Again, start very slowly. And now with the kick on only 1 and 3. Now, to make these combinations sound really broken, we'll start moving the kick around. To throw things into organized chaos, we'll play the kick on 1, the and of 2, and on 4, then run the previous exercises over this new kick pattern. First, we'll try the displaced 8th notes. Since the kick lands on only downbeats, or that 1 8th upbeat, it should never align with the hands once they start playing the 16th upbeats. Altogether, it'll sound like this. Let's try the same thing with the triplets. Now this gets kind of strange because we have an 8th note on the kick against 8th triplets on the snare. So the kick will align with the hand on beats 1 and 4 before we displace the hands, and once we displace the hands, the kick will only align on the and of beat 2. And it sounds like this. Once you feel confident keeping your hands locked onto all those 16th and 16th triplet upbeats, feel free to drop in the kick wherever the heck you'd like. You could also pepper in an extra stroke or two on the snare to occasionally touch upon the downbeats and the 8th upbeats. These fills should sound like popcorn. If you like what you saw in this video, check out my Patreon page. Your support grants you access to transcriptions for this video, as well as transcriptions for all my other lesson videos. And follow me on Instagram at drummerhar to see more videos of my playing. As always, thanks for watching and see you next time.